Good morning to all. I welcome you all to this didactic program. Thirukkurlod naam attending in fact with a noble desire to reach the seat of grace in life by practicing the ethical values of Thiruvalluvar.
Couplet number 384, chapter King's Strength. After tasting success in several parts of the world, the attention of the king Alexander the Great turned towards India. When he came to India with his army, provincial kings of India surrendered to his army and accepted his kingship. But Boris, alias Purushottaman, who was considered very brave and honest, put up a brave front and fought the Alexander's army. Though he got defeated in the war, he refused to accept the kingship of Alexander. Alexander appreciated the bravery of Porus and wanted to give him some kind of gift in turn. His soldiers told him that Porus was an upright in the battlefield, despite the fact that his soldiers ran away from the battlefield due to fear in their minds. But Porus stood all alone in the field and fought the army till the last minute. He was a great warrior, thus described the army soldiers of Alexander about Porus. Alexander was surprised at this and the strength and strong mindset of Porus. He liked to have a brave man like Porus in his army, and he expressed his desire to meet him. Porus, who was covered and tied with iron chain, was brought before Alexander, and he stood straight without any fear. Alexander told Porus to seek apology for his mistake. Porus, in turn, questioned Alexander why should he seek apology when he did not commit any mistake. Alexander said, "If apology is sought by you, then you too can become a king ruling your country under my control." Porus replied that it was not possible and that would not take place. Alexander asked Porus as to how he should conduct him. He said that he was a king and hence he should treat him as the king of a country. Seeing his bravery and strong confidence, he gave his country to Porus as his gift and made him rule again. While governing a country, the king should stand by the principles of Dharma and he should eliminate activities which are against Dharma. Besides, the king should not even show an iota of doubt over his bravery under all situations. Such a person is called the best of kings. Our Saint Tamil poet Thiruvalluvar illustrates the qualities of a king in his Thirukkural as follows. Aranilukka dallavai neeki maranilukka manam udayathu arasu. I recite. Aranilukka dallavai neeki maranilukka manam udayathu arasu. Cowardice is shame, bravery is fame. Thank you very much indeed. Nandri, vanakkam.
நாளைய நமது நல்லதொரு வாழ்விற்காக இன்றைய தங்களது அற்புதமான வாழ்வை அர்ப்பணிப்பவர்கள் நமது தேசம் காக்கும் காவல் படையினர். அவர்களது தியாகத்தினை போற்றி வணங்கிடும் நாள் வீர வணக்க நாள்.